Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Watch Natalie, spelled N-A-T-A-L-E-E. I am here to do your reading for the weekend, Saturday, June 8th and Sunday, June 9th, 2019. However, please keep in mind that time spirals. So what does that mean for energy? What it means is that you can resonate for this reading this weekend of June, whatever I just said, or you can resonate for it whenever you're guided to watch this video. If you feel connected to something I'm saying, or me, or a little part of this reading, or the whole reading, we are connected. Oh. Okay, they wanted me to start right away. This is exactly what I've been feeling this entire day. I try to get through the spiel. I couldn't even do it. This just popped out. It's a victory card. I've been feeling so excited all day today. I've just been like, just like this. Just like this. There's a whole something happening. Look at this. Is a victory card. Victory writing in. This is like the public. There's something public about this. So it's either like, you know, I've actually been a little too visibly happy, and it really puts some people off. You're gonna find the haters are getting even more hateful towards you because they don't really want you to proceed. They don't want you to spiritually evolve. They don't want you to make money. They don't want you to do well. And it's one of those indicators of the people closest to you, of, you know, are they really on your side? Probably not, to be honest. If you're watching me, if you're on the Watch Natalie Vibe Tribe, you're probably one, and you're the only one in your entire little group of life people that are at this vibration. So everyone else is probably going to be like, oh, you know, no, they're not. So don't let that put you off. Don't let that lower your vibrational frequency, because you are winning. You really are. I feel like this is you. This could be the other person that I'm channeling, though. I know. I can't. Even there's been so many downloads today. There's been a lot of downloads, but this victory happens in public. It happens in front of others. So that's why I said everything about the haters, but this is definitely something that's, I don't know if you're feeling it inside or if it's on its way to you or what. So use these energetic signatures as markers in time. Look at that, the Four of Staves and the Ten of Staves. So the staves are creativity. We just have three staves. Something super creative is happening. You're about to get super creative with the love of your life, or you're getting creative downloads. And that's another thing too, like between the downloads, the psychic downloads and the feelings and like the screenplay ideas, it's just been like really kind of crazy day. All day I've been like this, inside, just, okay. So this is like ultimate happiness. This is a big happiness card. 11-11, so it could be the whole 11-11 thing. So if you can tell, they're celebrating. Their arms are up in like victorious happiness. They are celebrating their love, their marriage, their partnership. So this is either you and the other person, or you and your partner. You know, you know, people coming together to celebrate something wonderful happening. This could be like a launch party even. It could even be, you know, toasting your glass at the incorporation documents that were filed and your operating agreement being filed with the state. It could be something like that too. Because this is also very legal. It's a very like, I'm buying a house with someone I love, or I'm moving in with someone I love, or, you know, it's got a very official thing, or maybe someone's putting their name on another contract and you're doing it together. So they're definitely celebrating. There's that whole, and it's like a freedom thing. Like if you're entering a new contract with someone, it's not restrictive of any way. It's very freeing, and you don't feel restricted by clauses or the other person. This is the Ten of Staves. This is like a burden, like a whole big burden, just like, but because it flew out with this card, what I'm thinking of is you're laying the burdens down. That's really what I'm feeling. I don't think it's like you're carrying. See this house, this castle in the back, and then see in this pictogram, the house in the back. I saw it because they're both yellow, like yellow and yellow. Huh. It's like, I think you're being smarter about how to carry these burdens. Oh, that's one of the downloads that was today. Today was about empowerment and actually laying down burdens and advocating for your own personal boundaries. That's a big deal. I'm resonating with that today. Like someone's really stepping into their power and defining these boundaries that separate. Boundaries are the space between you and the other person. It's where you end, that little space, and then where the other person begins. And it's, and I wanted to talk about financial boundaries that you're putting up between you and someone else. And the people that are really like the closest to us, our children, our spouses, our parents, you know, those people, it's so hard to have financial boundaries with them. It's so hard to have any kind of, you know, and especially when you're a child, you grow up and there's no boundaries between you and your parents. So then it evolves into this like monstrosity where it feels, it's so hard to overcome the whole point of the thing and to put up your own boundaries. But someone's doing that like a boss today. Someone's really, that's what I'm really channeling today, is that someone's just really victorious with themselves, with advocating for their own needs and putting self-love before someone else's. And and boundaries are also about, see, this is why it's a burden previously. They're putting the burden down so that they can have their own happiness. They're not taking responsibility for anyone else's happiness anymore. They're taking responsibility for their own happiness, and they're doing everything that they need to do to make it right in order to win. And they do. The first card I pull is always like this gel, like the gel that colors like the rest of the reading. And this, that's exactly what I was feeling today. One of the downloads of many. Oh my God. Okay. I don't know who's excited. I don't know if it's just me. I don't know if it's you. I don't know if it's the other person. No idea. But I've just been really, really happy and excited today. And nothing's particularly special going on. Did you see how it just like flew? I don't know if you saw it, but it just went like, it like floated along and landed like a bird. That's another thing that I channeled today. I had this moment a few days ago where I was watching this beautiful cardinal fly across my car as I was driving, and then yesterday it was a blue jay, and then there's this other, I was watching this bird today talking to the other birds, and it just reminded me of this thing I used to do when I was a kid. One of the little psychic parlor tricks that I used to be able to do. I haven't tried this, haven't done this in forever, but when I was super little, I could put myself in a state where Ace Ventura Pet Detective, where all the animals would just come over to me. They would all just come to me and just be very comfortable and calm, and just like the single girl with the falcon, they would just, and I haven't been able to do it. I haven't even tried doing it in forever, but I thought about that, watching like these birds flying around. Anyway, so this judgment card is the final judgment. And remember, we've been channeling this card for quite some time now. So this is that the sound, it's like they've heard the trumpet sound. They've heard, this is real do or die. This is getting really exciting. This is like where everyone's like just tweaking out, like my antenna are going like, yours are probably too. But this is when they rise. They rise up from the dead. Remember? Let me do that again. They rise forward to ascend, to go up for their final judgment. What have they made of their lives? What do they have to show for themselves? So I think like, I feel like someone's feeling like this, and there was some of that regret over the mistakes of the past, you know, worrying and anxiety about being judged. But it's you. Only you have the judgment over your life. No one's been there with you from the beginning until right now, except for you. You're the one who's going to make the final judgment on your own life. See, I think this is self-reflective, because I feel like counterparts, they've already made the judgment about the clarity, that clarity video. It's like they know you're the one. You know they're the one. And then it's, well, how do we go in? Then there was that double Dutch, remember? Whoa. So this is a judgment of a different source. This is a judgment of the self, a judgment of how I'm going to treat myself. And from now on, I'm going to, number one, establish and maintain my personal and professional boundaries. Number two, I'm going to forgive myself for all the horrible things I did when I was evil. Number three, I'm going to go after everything that I want in life because I know I deserve it and I love myself in order to get that for myself. Number four, I'm going to have a treat. I don't know. Let's see what else is coming up. I dreamt of my soulmate last night. In my dreams, I always see his face. I can like see him and talk to him and like interact, and it's lovely. And then when I wake up, I don't remember his face. Isn't that weird? But I saw his hands. So you know how my hand is very like sort of long and slender like? I think it's either this bone or that bone really juts out. It really is like, it's very like wide right here. It's very strange. Weird too. Don't laugh at me, but he gets manicures. It was like a very manicured hand. Short, you know, nails, not like long nails like mine, but like short and like moisturized and manicured. Like oh dear God, sorry. Okay. That was so loud. The chariot comes forth. So this is another victory card. Ooh, I feel like he's just getting courageous in his heart. He's finding his mojo. Remember we were channeling like just the other day that he had to get his mojo back? He's definitely getting it back. And it's, you know, this is a oh shit. Okay, we got more cards too. But let's talk about this one first. We got to go A, B, C, D. We can't go to A to Z without stopping at any other letter in between. This is the chariot. This is another victory card. Okay, these are both, and they're both public victories. This is like that politician's victory, acceptance speech victory. Look at, they're riding in the public like arena. They have to do like a round, a tour, a press thingy. What is it? What's it when you do the press and you go around everywhere and talk about things? They do that. That's what this is. This is that too. It could be a new car, but that's so generic. This is an athletic victory. This is a competitive victory. This is, I'm slaying the competition because I was the only choice ever, obviously. Okay. And because he has this, not cabana, what's it called? Canopy? Is that the word? He has this thing up top. It's blue with those little stars. That means that the stars. This is like a very star-like influence that's like blessing him. He has the blessing of the cosmos above him to go forth. He has the two sphinxes down here that he has tamed them. He has figured out their riddles and now they do his bidding. Now they go forth for him. They take him. They don't stop him as an obstacle. They take him where he wants to go. He has everything he needs for victory. I mean, he is victorious. He has a wand. I mean, he's great. Okay. The next card, these four cards came out together, and I will go in order that they came out. So they're like a little stack. The first one is the Queen of Swords. Now, we've talked about this person before, and we've talked about a lower vibrational Queen of Swords, and we've talked about high vibrational Queen of Swords. So this doesn't, remember, fudge the genders, the signs, and the ages. Okay, because this Queen of Swords, it could be you, it could be the other person, it could be another person in the situation. So take it as it resonates and use the energy and just, you know, it should click intuitively in your mind who I'm talking about. This is the one who's giving permission. You may rise to honor me. You know, but she's just like strategic. This is what I'm getting from her is that she's smart, she's intellectual, she's strategic, but I feel like she's a supporter. I feel like she is a supporter to the other person in this scenario. Strategy. She's a strategist. Okay. The one after that, the Seven of Swords. This is someone, this is what I'm thinking. I think this is the other person. I don't, whether it's male or female, it doesn't matter. I feel like this person, either you or the other person, is trying to strategize how they're going to escape. Look at how he's running. He's escaping these tents, like this, like Coachella looking thing, right? There's two swords here and he's walking away. He's trying to sneak away with what's left. And so this is just super sneaky, but I don't get anything negative on it. And I remember, we don't make judgments on Watch Natalie. We'd rather understand than judge. So I feel like what I'm getting is that this person is trying to strategize their escape from either bad situations or the boundaries. Someone that they're trying to erect boundaries with, they're trying to do it in a way where they're like, it's like this could be a parent, it could be a sibling, it could be someone that you don't really feel like you're going to just, you know. I'm not going to talk about myself because it's a whole different thing. I don't know your life. I don't know what you got going on. Some of you will just close the door on a relationship. Some of you will try to keep that relationship and put a lot of distance between you and the other person. So if you have a parent that lives, that you both live in the same state, you might just move to another state and never have a confrontational type conversation with them. You'll just be more distant and they'll just find it harder to get a hold of you, that kind of thing. That's really what I get. This is not, now the swords, the King and Queen of Swords are like conversation, okay? It is like conversation, mental, you know, things like that. So I feel like this conversation is not very as direct as this card implies. Coming out with this card, I feel like this conversation is a little bit, not deceptive in a bad way, but it's not really, see, I'm super direct and it's very clear about, you know, what boundary you're encroaching on and why I believe that, you know, it's all very clear, very transparent, very direct. That's why people say I'm super harsh or they're scared of me or whatever, because they pick up that Queen of Swords energy. Even when I'm not trying to be tonally harsh, I will just come across that way because I'm so confident, so direct, and so specific. I'm extremely specific. I have a good memory. I reference a lot of different things that support my statements, you know, so nothing's ever, you know, I reference exact things that people said, actor stuff. So it catches people off guard, but this is more like doing that, but not so direct. It's doing that, but doing it in a way where you're kind of sneaking out the back. You're kind of like, have a great trip, or, you know, whatever it is. And okay, enough of that. So they're telling me move on. The last two cards that came out with these two cards, these were like the front end, the back end, the Holy Grail of relationships and the Ten of Pentacles, lasting happiness. Whatever relationship is literally just around the corner, it's gonna pop before or at the eclipse in July 2nd. This is forever. This is lasting happiness. This is the cup that is never empty. No matter how much you drink from it, it overflows. It's bottomless. The love is bottomless. The love goes back. The love is just more and more and more and more and more the longer that you're together. And this is longevity. The pentacles take the longest to manifest in the 3D plane, but they last the longest. That's why Capricorns, Taurus, Virgos, and Tauruses, that's why we're late bloomers. Let's put it that way. We're late bloomers, but we last super long. Okay. Look, he has everything. He has health. He has wealth. He has progeny. He has his house. He has his companions. He has everything. He's comfortable. He's sitting down. He doesn't have to stand. Okay, this is what someone's working on. They can almost taste it. They can almost drink from the cup. They can almost say, but that's what this is. And they're doing this to get to here. They're doing this. It's like they're trying to put up a boundary. It's boundary. Everything's like boundary, boundary, boundary. It's like they're trying to do it in a way where it's not going to really hurt. So they're trying to really do this without hurting people. And they're still and when you're doing that, you're still kind of, let me tell you something. This is a very highly evolved person because they're understanding these things and they understand what they have to do and they're trying to do it. So it's a very highly evolved person. However, the fact that they're trying to do this without hurting someone, you think that it's considerate. You think that they're being kind. However, that's still a remnant of taking responsibility for someone else's feelings. We don't do that. You want to sit there and be a grouchy person, that's your free will choice. It has nothing to do with me. If you want to sit there being upset about whatever, that has nothing to do with me. If you want to sit there and blame me for you being miserable, That has nothing to do with me, and you're wrong, because you control your own feelings. And just because you think you're giving me the power to hurt you that makes me responsible for how you feel, you are wrong. And I can't help you realize that. Especially if you don't want to understand that. Especially if you want to make me responsible for how you feel. And you're very resistant to the truth. Swords are the truth. So here we have a very truthful woman using her truth to cut to the heart of the matter. But with her we have the Seven of Swords. It's the most truthy, bendy, bendy, truthy card. Right? So it's like, ooh, or this could be someone around you being that way with you. Take it as it resonates. You should know. I don't really think that though. You or the other person trying to like get to the lasting happiness with as little carnage as possible. See, I will blow it all up. Ooh. My philosophy used to be a simple line. If something can be destroyed by the truth, it should be. That's how I lived my life. Then that stuff with my dad blew up and I'm like, damn, I was really put to the test. And that's the truth. That's my truth. That's how I live my life. If it doesn't survive the truth, it shouldn't survive. Even if it's my best friend since a little itty bitty baby. It's not the truth. So what am I really losing? I'm a very picky eater. I like very simple foods. People would always say, oh, Natalie, you don't know what you're missing. 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 I would say, if I don't know what I'm missing, how can I miss it? But it's very nice that other people are trying to do things without hurting people. Let's give them credit for being nice. I'm Capricorn, so it's so let me get back in here. Okay, give me a second here. They're just trying to do strategy. This is deceptive, or it's common sense, or street smarts, sorry, street smarts. Street smarts. It's strategy. At least they know at this point that this cannot go on in this way. So they're trying to employ the best strategy. And it's not even, okay, that's what it is. It's not that they're trying to do it without carnage and hurting people's feelings. Then they're really high evolved. Take it as it resonates. For some of you, the former will be true. Some of you, the latter will be true. But this, no, I know what this is now. Damn. They know that it is inappropriate for certain people. It is financial. Someone's been taking financial advantage of someone. It's like a burden it's like a burden that's turned into a debt or something that's turned into a, and what they're doing here is they're trying, the two swords, see, he's leaving those two swords there on purpose. He's like leaving some money for you to live off of. But then that means I get my fucking freedom and you don't ever ask me for anything ever again. This is enough to hold you over. This is her giving permission for the fuck you money. But other people don't know it's the fuck you money. They might feel it on some level, and they're still going to take it because people are just going to, they're going to take the free money that you give them. But just because they want it from you doesn't mean they're entitled to it from you. Okay? So oh my God. This is someone giving someone the fuck you money. Could be mom, dad, brother, sister, but it's close. It's someone close to you. Because look, they were your burden, that you're putting the burden down to live your own life. This is the Some of you could be like a child support thing. It could be like a previous, I don't know, but it's a karmic, family karmic thing. Shit. Yeah, someone's leaving behind the fuck you money. And they're getting away with their, okay, now don't fuck with me ever again. Because I need to go out in my 11-11 Four of Stave life. I want my Four of Staves happiness. I want my ceremony. Then they will feel better about marching into the new life. Then they can take the money, the little bit of money that they have left over, and they can put it into where it really will give back to them. They've been putting money into people out of guilt or out of manipulation, you know, and it hasn't been giving them anything in return. It's just been people taking from them, taking, taking, taking. And now they want to put it into something that's going to be overflowing with value that returns to them. That Marion Davies anecdote I shared yesterday. Jeez Louise. So 10 of Pentacles is what they're trying to do this for the long run. They're trying to build for the long run. It's such a deep love. What did I just say? I just said it was such a deep love. So these two came out together, the Page of Wands and the Queen of Cups. She could have something to say. There could be a message coming to her. The Page of Wands, very creative energy. But the pages communicate. They communicate information, okay? So information or notifications or, you know, something of that sort could be coming to the Queen of Cups, or she's sending it out. She's sending the transmission out. Two queens, how interesting. Remember, fudge the genders and the signs and the ages. But this is showing up as an emotionally mature feminine. Okay? So take that as it resonates. Highly creative, though. Highly creative. It's like she has to be psychic, or she has to have a feeling. She has to have an intuition about it. She's the only one that knows what's inside that cup. It's the only chalice in the deck that's closed. These people are very evolved. They're evolving fast. Remember, Divine Feminines, you have to give him time, but I don't think he's going to need as much time. I think he's like that Hierophant energy now, like Emperor. He's stepping into his power. This is powerful. Oh my God. Oh my God. Who's got the power? The Divine Feminine. Holy cow. The Empress is everything Venusian, the ideal female. She's fertile. She's gracious. She's loving. She's pure. She's vulnerable. She's strong. She's empowering. She multiplies wealth. The Queen of Pentacles multiplies wealth. We have three queens now. Holy cow. Oh my God. The Queen of Pentacles multiplies pentacles. She alone creates wealth. She alone multiplies wealth. She alone is in tune with her own divine timing and to plant, when to plant seeds, when to reap the harvest, when to do all of those. She knows the timing of her life alone. With the Empress, it's like multiplied a millionfold. This is, what was I just talking about? Very evolved people, very evolved. They're here to it feels like they're going to do something with their wealth and with their like image, their victory, their public victory, and their wealth is, they're like tools. It's part of their magician's toolbox that they use in their journey, in their lives. So it doesn't matter. The fuck you money doesn't matter. Because these two together, once they get together, it's just, what I just saw, what is that? It's like bubble universes or it just like rapidly expanding universes, you know? He knows it too. He's growing fast. He's growing so fast. Day to day, this individual, whether you or the other person, this individual is growing really fast. Day by day. I'm telling you, it took me 6 months. It took me 6 months from my tower moment to my self-completion, like putting myself together, fully manifested, complete, like rejuvenated, super strong person. 6 months. Yeah. October to March. It was recent, I know. I grew fast too. I go fast. But this is a high. So think about it. Remember, this is a portal. The portal that opened in January to July. 6 months. This is another highly evolved person, another soul that's really, something started in January. They're going from January to July, just like I went from October. And remember, who else had some shit blow up in October? Raise your hand. Who else? Yeah, 6 months, October to March, and then the feminine leads. So in this case, October to March. January to July. That fits. I mean, that fits for me. I don't know if that fits for you guys, but take it as it resonates. Fudge the, you know what I said. But this person is really evolving quickly. I mean, every day it's like they're like, I mean, they're just like, they're, I'm telling you, every single day, they are getting that much closer, that much stronger. And so are you, Divine Feminine, because you lead the way. You are showing him how to do this. The more you strengthen up, the more you grow and manifest inside, the more spiritually awakened you get, the more psychically you develop, he's connected to you. You're connected to each other, and you're already together on the 5D. That's why everyone commenting saying, yeah, I know. Where is it already? What's the fucking hold up? Yeah, because it already feels like you're together, because you are. And you're just like, damn. I channeled you again today. I think I was just spacing out in the car driving. And then it came in. It was a feeling and a thought of, oh, another beautiful day. What another beautiful day that I could have been with my counterpart. Another day wasted. Oh, shit. There was a phrase. Hold on. You said something. Someone said something, or the feeling it was a day off the end. Something like that. It's like a day off, taken off the end. So from until you meet, there's your life. And then when you meet until one of you dies, there's a finite number of days. A finite number of days that you will be with this other person until one of you dies. And you haven't met yet. So it's like someone was thinking or feeling, oh, what a beautiful day. I'm so happy. I'm living my best life. But it's a day off the end. A day less than what we could have had. Because when the sun rises, it gives us a whole nother day of life, another day of experiencing something fucking magical. And when the sun sets, it takes that day from us. It takes that day of life from us. Whatever we made of it, it's what we made of it. Whatever happened, whatever didn't happen, it's gone. And that was the feeling that came up. It was, oh, it was a beautiful day, but it was a day off the end. It was a beautiful day, but it was a day off the end. Oh, something like that. Like a day less, you know? So I feel that. I totally feel it. We can't rush it. This person's already, but I'm telling you, this other counterpart, whether you or the other person, growing fast, very fast. And there's incredible fertility here. There's incredible, incredible fertility, fecundity, growth, abundance. This is abundance, abundance. I can't, where's the thesaurus? Abundance, okay? The Queen of Pentacles coming out with the Empress. This is material. This is financial abundance. So, oh my God, and we've been talking about financial boundaries. Oh my God, I can't even, I'm so proud of myself. Okay, so that's why he's able to give the fuck you money to mom, to dad, to Joe Schmo brother, to trampy little sister, to whoever. Because number one, it's the last fucking money you're getting from me. And number two, because he knows that abundance. He's about to be richest beyond his wildest dreams. With you in every single way, shape, and form. Long-lasting emotional happiness. Spiritual happiness. Remember, it's a sanctuary. You two, that's what my dream felt like last night. I was so comfortable and I was so happy and so comfortable and I was just like snuggling against him. And I was trying to stay awake in the dream. And I was trying to stay awake. And it's like his shoulder was right here and I was like, laying on him, and I was just so happy, but I was so comfortable, I was so relaxed. And you know, for me, it was like I just want to be out of fucking danger, you know, that was like my thing in the past. But in the dream, I just felt so safe and protected, you know. That's why I love Soho House. It wasn't because it was super fucking dorky pretentious, but I just felt safe. I just felt, God, it'd be so hard to kill me up here because they'd have to get through the people down there, you know. I just felt safe in this dream last night that I could relax, and I got sleepy and I was trying to stay awake, and that's when I saw his hands and then I fell asleep in the dream. But you two are about to have everything. And for this mask, you know, he might not have, see, he didn't have any of this before. Spiritual and remember the beast, Beauty and the Beast. What did the beast really have? He had the biggest fucking castle in the land. Empty. Remember Walk the Line? Remember Walk the Line when the Thanksgiving dinner happens and he's like, "You, what do you got here? Big old house with nobody in it. Big old tractor stuck in the mud. You ain't got nothing. You don't have a wife, you ain't got your kids, you ain't got fucking nothing. You don't have progeny, you don't have companions, you don't have love, you don't have a life, you don't have nothing." That was so mean. I'm so sorry it came out like that. But that was, that's the scene that, and you know, but this masculine, this person, all he kind of had or has is like money. And that's what people were like taking advantage of him and like financially, I get financial abuse here. And that's why like financial boundaries came in so strong for me today, I feel like. So, oh, that hurts. Oh, damn. I think I said something about taking someone on a date and not leading with materialism. Put it this way. this person, they remember, they compartmentalize, they don't treat people respectfully, or maybe women, or maybe mom issues, whatever it is, or even anyone speaking sort of disrespectfully, right? You and loving you has changed them, is changing them, and it's empowering them to grow fast. So if you are the light, if you are the sanctuary, if you are the peace and the love and the spirituality, he's the money. Doesn't have to be that way, but it's like what he has. It's like all he has. And that is what he will. I'm almost there. There's something I'm not putting together about this. I'm going to pull another card, but true counterparts. You bring in what he lacks and he brings in what you lack or could use more of. However it works, but there's like a balance. There's like a temperance balance. We got that. I got that a couple of days in a row too. That the cups, right? Wow, you really fill, you fill him though. You really give the, you give what's lacking and you give so much of it to overflowing. Overflowing, that he's able to, like, he's gonna do it. This is a very worth the wait. I just heard it. It's worth the wait. Worth the wait. And use discernment about all of this. Don't try to make it fit, okay? If it fits, it fits. If a part fits, a part fits. This individual sees so much in you, or vice versa. Take it how it resonates. Look at this. I mean, they just see everything. They see their future with you. They see long-term happiness, stability, true love, wealth. Like, you guys are going to make, remember the business thing, how you guys come together and do business? Maybe you two come together to incorporate something that's going to really save the fucking planet. I was talking to my wealth manager, my financial person, and we were talking about an IPO. We were talking about something. And we were talking about Tesla. Then we started talking about Tesla. Oh, we're talking about different IPOs, right? Like throughout time. And I said something about Tesla and she said, well, yeah, they don't make any money. I said, okay, what about the gigafactory? Like we need like 100 gigafactories. I think I remember to like save the planet. That's kind of like the general, don't quote me on that. But that's like the general thing that I remember. And she goes, well, it needs to make money. It needs to be sustainable. I said, sustainable for who? If it saves the planet, it saves the planet. And she goes, well, it's the government that's supposed to do things for the good of everyone without needing to turn a profit. I said, okay, but the administration's going to change. Why would that? What the fuck is that? It should be a corporation that's going to outlast and have the longevity to ride out all the different administrations that come and go. And she goes, well, if it doesn't turn a profit, it's not sustainable. I said, sustainable for the earth? And then she cut me off and she said, well, if a company doesn't make money is not sustainable in 10 years, it won't exist. I said, if it's not sustainable for the fucking planet, it won't matter. That's the whole point of the environmental documentary about, I blank on the most simplest things, but anyway. What was I going to say? Oh, yeah. So maybe you two use your financial multiplication magic to do something good for like the greater good. But it's going to make you see energy. Money's energy. Okay. Money's energy. And this feminine knows how to manipulate it and make it bigger, multiply it and like use it and channel the divine and put it into the, I mean, it's like a whole thing. So he sees it. He's paying attention. That's what it was. Paying attention. Remember I channeled that yesterday, the day before? Paying attention. somebody is now finally really paying attention, and they're in like a meaningful attention. Meaningful attention. There's something I'm still missing about the financial. Okay. Look at it. It's the Fool. Ah. Okay. I mean, was this on the bottom of the deck yesterday? I forgot. I think it was. I was going to get one more card, and it's already there. I feel like, remember, I'm going to say it again. This is the last lunar cycle before those eclipses. The eclipse season comes back. It's that boomerang. This is the window. The window is not time. Ooh, see, there's also, there are other tarot readers on YouTube. There's one tarot reader I like. She's always wrong about my love life. Completely wrong. Always consistently wrong about my love life. Her readings for me and my love life, always wrong. But she's always precision correct on my family life. On my family dynamics. So weird, right? And that's why it's great to just see different flavors and different, you know, types of things. And she channeled something last week that I channeled many weeks ago. I forgot when remember when I saw my children? Remember when I talked about making the bodies? That's coming back up because it's like, I get a bloodline thing here. I get a mixing of the fluids. Okay. He's looking at what he created, his wealth in many different forms, wealth of progeny and legacy and wealth of pentacle. Okay. She channeled the Arwen scene in Lord of the Rings, how Arwen saw, she's so cute. She channeled the Arwen scene where Arwen sees her son. She's like, I have a son. And I hadn't thought about it. Honestly, I hadn't even thought. I forgot about, I remember like the gist of readings, but I don't remember a lot of the specifics. I know this one, I'm going to like, I was all hyped up in the beginning that I'm sure, I don't know what I said. I'm sure I said a lot of different stuff. But she channeled that Arwen scene. And then it reminded me of when I had that experience and I channeled, and you know, that all that came into place. And I don't know where we, oh my God. Okay, I'm taking the last four cards. The Leap of Faith. The nuts and bolts of taking the leap of faith. Working together. Working together. Remember, collaboration. It's time. I was wondering when I was going to start getting this card. It's time. This is what I use for timing. Wheel of Fortune, divine timing. The wheel. And I started channeling. We got this card before. Like, I don't remember when, but we did. We got it in a couple readings in a row. We were getting it. It was coming up. The timing was coming up. And I feel like that was probably trying to tell me when, about the, it was waiting for me. They were waiting for me to put it together. They were waiting for me to put together. The portal is not a time portal. It's an energy portal. And that's something that other readers haven't cracked yet. But I think they're going to. It's an energy portal. And the eclipses and the eclipse season, January to July, it's easy to demarcate because it is time. It's January and July. The eclipses in January and February and the eclipses in July. Like, it's easy to say that that's time. But what it really is the trigger, the floodlight of energy. And what the eclipses are kicking off energetically. Remember, time goes like this, guys. So what does that mean for energy? And what does that mean when astrological events in the sky start to happen? Just like this. See? Just like all the stars. Okay? What does that mean? It means we're all getting jolt. We're all like reacting. We're all like, you know, but remember, the stars incline, they do not compel. It's soon. It's before July 2nd. It could be around the full moon. You know what? It's do or die. He is growing fast, and I'm so proud of him. I'm so proud. Oh, that was so funny. Who was that, Luis, when you said maybe I'm channeling for myself? Or that'd be hilarious. I'm very happy to live vicariously through your guys' story. That would be funny. But no, there's no... It's just you guys watching me on YouTube. But for you guys, for someone here, look at these four. I'm reading these like a glob. And they came out like this. First, it was the Fool taking the leap of faith. The nuts and bolts of taking the leap of faith, organizing plane tickets, clear my schedule. I have to go to collaboration. See, but I feel it. I'm feeling it for you. I'm feeling it for someone. I'm just like feeling it. I'm feeling him. I'm feeling you. I'm feeling it. I'm like, you know, feeling the whole energy. I'm like a little beacon for it. Okay. And it's like, awesome. Good vibrations. And then it's the Wheel of Fortune. It's the time. He's double dutching, but he's going to jump in. That's what it is. He's going to jump in. And when she gets it, it will be the whirlwind. It will be like a fire hose. It will see, the Page of Wands is like fiery. The wands are fiery communication, fiery. The Queen of Wands is very fiery, spicy, you know, fierce, just very, you know, and that's this Page of Wands. The Page of the communication is very bold. It's bold. Thank you. It's bold communication. Bold communication coming to her or from her. Okay. Oh my God. It's with us. I don't know when he's going to get it together, but it's happening. He's every day. It's like he has his own like epiphany. Every day he has his own self-reflective feeling. Your love is changing him in the 5D trickling down to the 3D. It's been changing him since January, February. Look at the eclipses. Eclipses last a while, like 6 months or whatever. So something's been happening. That's the portal that opened. The portal opened and then you connected. That's the portal. When you two really connected, or he was made aware, or you came up on his radar, or you met, or someone introduced you, something. There's some spark. Where did I just put it? The Page of Wands is also a spark, like a spark of communication. It's like, it's more than one kind of leap of faith. It's more than one kind of, because remember, he does not mix business with girlfriends or with females. He doesn't do that. God, he's grown up so much. Oh my God, I'm already so proud of him. Do you guys remember? You guys have been with me channeling this energy. We know where he started. We know all the pain, all the abuse, all the hurt, and then feeling guilty about. Let me tell you something. Before you learn how to treat yourself and how to treat other people and how to teach other people how to treat you, you will hurt yourself and you will hurt others. That's just the truth. I hurt myself. I hurt others. I was not very nice. But does that mean that I don't deserve love? No, of course not. So he had to go through, remember, he's had to go through detoxing the heart. And however old he is, however much experience he has living that life, that empty life of only having money and then and people only appreciating him for what he can do for them, is going to dictate how impressive it is that he's doing this so fast. Because whether he's short experience, younger guy, more experienced, older gentleman, he's getting through it. He's like really, he's evolving fast. And you have everything to do with that, Divine Feminine, if that is who I am talking to. So give yourself a pat on the back. Because you are really manifesting this whole thing. He's taking the cue from you. Look at this. Look at this. Oh my God. It's just the most romantic. It's just the most romantic ever. The right time. Double Dutch. I'm not going to mess this up. I'm going to shoot my shot, hit the bullseye. I'm going to hit it right in the bullseye. He might, this pentacle, this offer, remember the employment or the love, how is he going to, whatever. It could be, what he does have to offer you, he's going to make the most of it. Whatever he does have. So if you're the one bringing this, he's going to be the one to bring this. I think this is going to end right here. I felt the joy today. I felt immense joy, incredible excitement. I can't remember the other downloads, I'm sorry. It was like a fire hose of joy, though. It was just so much excitement. So much excitement. Remember, that's what I meant to tell you. Remember, anger has its place in our life. Anger is a red flag to alert us when someone's encroaching on our boundaries. Someone overcame anger today. Someone overcame misuse of anger. Someone noticed they were angry and were self-aware and said, oh, I know why I'm angry, because this person is encroaching on my financial boundary. So I'm going to make this right the right way. And then they did or said something that was without the anger. That's what it is. They do this without emotion. Oh, fuck. Oh, my God. That's it. Oh, my God. That's it. Oh, I'm so happy I got it. It was just like a psychic little splinter that I just had to like pick out. Okay, that's what it was. They're able to do these, make these changes and get where they need to go and get out of what they need to get out of without emotion, because they cannot be manipulated by emotion anymore. They cannot be guilt tripped. They cannot be guilt tripped. They cannot be led into taking responsibility for other people's emotions anymore. They cannot be led to take responsibility for other people's financial hardships, financial difficulties. They cannot be manipulated into taking responsibility for other people's responsibilities. No more. No more. I'm so proud of all of you. Let me know how this goes. I have to log into my email account on Safari to answer the emails that you're sending to thefirstartegan@gmail.com. I'm just getting them on my phone, so I'm not sitting there typing out a whole long thing. I will do that soonly. Oh, am I still going live tomorrow night? Oh, I kind of want to take it back, but maybe I'll come on at 9 o'clock CST. I guess I will. I said I was. That was something I forgot about. Totally forgot about. Then I saw a comment that someone's like, okay, I'll see you tomorrow. I was like, oh my God. Oh, but it might be fun. You know, like date night or something. Okay, everybody. Oh, that feels good. Oh my God, are you so excited? I'm so excited. There's nothing on the horizon for me. I'm just so excited for you guys. Send me pictures of the wedding. Oh. Okay, I'll see you guys later. Goodbye.